All right, joining us with reaction to the predictable left-wing, well, response to the ongoing Supreme Court opening, he is the host of CRTV's Levin TV, the host of the number one show, Sunday nights, 10 p.m. It's called Life, Liberty, and Levin. I call him the great one. All right, before we get into it, we do have a big announcement. Do you want to say it or shall I, Mr. Great One, sir?
I'll say it. I'm pregnant. No, I actually...
Mark has just been appointed to the Supreme Court. Yeah, that'll
exactly.
Scare the crap out of everybody that's on the left.
Well, I just self-identified. Well, you know, you are my guest on Life, Liberty, and Levin.
For
so we're
going to
kind of switch roles where I interview for an hour.
By the way, that role reversal thing is a little weird for me. I think it's a great show. Thank you for having me, by the way. All right, Mark, Liberty, you're probably best known for your massive runaway bestseller, and all your books have been number one bestsellers, but Liberty and Tyranny. But I remember you wrote a book called Men in Black. And long before anybody else, you talked about this, what the left can't accomplish in an election, what they can't accomplish ever legislatively. They want to ignore separation of powers, co-equal branches. They'll cite foreign law, and they literally want things legislated from the bench. You have been way ahead of the curve, but this president wants to choose an originalist. I want you to go through their reaction to this opening now, what it means for the country.
First of all, I want Americans to understand that the progressive ideology, which you hear on the left, is incompatible with constitutionalism. And so they've turned the Supreme Court, into a Politburo, into a all-powerful, centralized political operation where they want to control a majority of the seats. You notice they don't talk about upholding the Constitution as written. You notice they don't talk about this article, this provision, this section, this clause of the Constitution. When you hear them yap away on the other networks, they're talking about abortion on demand, same-sex marriage, Obamacare, open borders. They give you the same left-wing agenda as if they're running for president or running for the Senate that they want in a judicial nominee. That's not how it works. Sean, we don't want a conservative. We don't want a liberal. We want a constitutionalist. A constitutionalist is somebody who has sworn to uphold the Constitution, looks at the Constitution, looks at the words, takes them in context, tries to figure out what the original intent was, and applies it. And the parties before the Supreme Court have a right to expect that that's what the justices will do. What the Democrats are telling the president of the United States is if you don't nominate Ruth Bader Ginsburg in one form or another, we're going to oppose whomever you nominate. So the Republicans are going to have to steamroll the Democrats, and that's okay. The Democrats have politicized this process where they don't even make any sense. They used to support filibustering it. Now they oppose filibustering it. They used to oppose a nomination with 1 year left in the presidency. Now they support it or they don't support it. Now they oppose it when it's midterm elections. In other words, forget about Schumer, forget about the Democrats, forget about their agenda, and let us uphold the Constitution with our nomination. And I think this president, more than most, understands that. He ran for office. He had his list. He was extremely transparent. Hillary Clinton didn't have a list because the nation collectively would have puked, quite frankly. But this president had his list. He has tremendous candidates on this list. And he said, I'm going to choose from this list. So the left has every opportunity to dig up whatever they can on these various candidates, and the president's sticking to the list. And this is very, very important. The Supreme Court is not supposed to be more powerful than the other two branches of government. It's supposed to be independent from them. Justices are appointed for life because they're not to be political. It's gotten way out of whack. And under the left, it'll be more out of whack. Here's the attitude of the progressives, who really used to attack the Constitution, you know, as written by a bunch of white men who own slaves. Now they pretend to support it. Here's the position of the left, basically. They want to enshrine their ideology into the Constitution. When they say you have to support precedent, they don't really believe that. Dred Scott upholding slavery, that was precedent. Plessy versus Ferguson, segregation, that was precedent. Korematsu, the internment of Japanese Americans, that was precedent. Do they support that precedent? No, what they mean is the most radical decisions of the Supreme Court, that's what they want to compel, that's what they believe in. Not the Constitution, but the leftist direction that leftist courts have taken the Constitution.
I don't even know what year you wrote Men in Black. I assume that it's out in print.
2005, I think.
All right, and I just look. One of the reasons we became friends, and I think we go into this a little bit. I don't remember the whole discussion, but Mark, we became friends because of issues, and I'm going to tell a little bit of the story. Is with all due respect to you, I have to twist your arm to do fill in for me on radio, twist your arm to do a weekend show, twist your arm to do it 6 to 8, then 6 to 9, then syndicate. And to be honest, it's been years I've been twisting your arm to come on this TV show. And now you're here. And now you flipped it, and now I have to do your show. But the thing is, what brought us together is our belief in conservatism.
I agree. But I want your viewers to know something, because we just did this interview. I want the viewers to know more about you than when you're on TV. And that's what we're doing in this interview. You've got a wonderful background. You've got a great sense of humor. You're one of the most decent human beings I know.
Okay.
You're under constant attack from the left. Hold on now. You gave me $20. I got to finish. You're under constant attack from the left. And I want the people to know really the real Sean Hannity. And that's what's going to happen.
By the way, I did something that a lot of politicians and liberals do. Mark would try to get me to talk about me, and I kept talking about issues. And finally, he said, now, stop it. Talk about you. Mark, your love of this Constitution has been your life study. I mean this. I absorb this because this is important. I swear, if we don't get this right, we're going to lose this country. We talk about rule of law, equal application of our laws, our constitutional form of government, the foundation of all our laws, and you have been an intellectual heavyweight on all of this. Thank you. Let me just say one thing. Last thing, yeah.
On the Supreme Court. No. The progressives don't own the Supreme Court. They don't own seats on the Supreme Court. When they talk about the Supreme Court's going to move hard to the right, it doesn't move hard to the right. You either believe in the Constitution or you don't. We define everything through the left. We see everything through the left. Stop. We want candidates who are going to uphold the Constitution,
Amen.
Not drive their political agenda through the Constitution.
You like Mike Lee.
I would support, if the president's watching, Mike Lee is your best choice. That's my humble opinion. I think he would be absolutely outstanding.
I think Mike Lee would be an outstanding justice, and he's brilliant. He would be a great choice. Mark, Life, Liberty, and Levin, every Sunday night, the number one show on cable at 10 Eastern on Sundays, and I'm unfortunately the guest, and he beats me up this Sunday night. Hope you'll watch.